We're going to solve the following equation in this video, which is an equation that isn't quadratic in form. So what we're trying to do is make it look like something like this. We want to somehow, instead of writing the x to the 2/3 and x to the 1/3, we're trying to get something in this form. So we discussed this on the previous video, and you have something that's quadratic in form if whatever you have for the exponent on the middle term, you have to double that for the exponent for the first term. Okay, so if we look back at here, we have 1/3 for the exponent on x, 2/3 on the exponent for the first term, and so therefore you see the first exponent is twice as big. 2 times 1/3 is 2/3. So that's going to be our strategy here. Okay, so what we notice is this is quadratic in form because of the exponents. I've got 1/3 for the exponent for my middle term, and this is twice as big. So the way we could use the substitution is let u equal this one in the middle, the x to the 1/3. So when I square u, it's x to the 1/3 squared gives you x to the 2/3. All right? Because when you square that, remember you could think of it as x to the 1/3 times x to the 1/3 and add exponents, or you can use the laws of exponents where you multiply 1/3 times 2 to get the 2/3. Okay, so either way. Right, so now what we're going to do is go back and substitute u or u squared in for the x to the 2/3 or x to the 1/3. So this becomes u squared minus u minus 6 equals 0. Now this looks like a quadratic. That's why this was called quadratic in form. But it's a lot easier to work with just u squared minus u minus 6. So first we see if we could factor it, and we can. So let's see. We are going to get a u minus 3 times a u plus 2 is equal to 0. That's the correct factorization. And so we set each factor equal to 0. U minus 3 is 0, or u plus 2 is 0. So u is 3, or u is negative 2. And the trick is to realize you are not done. That tells you what u is equal to, but the original problem had an x. What we're looking for are the solutions for x. So we have to now go back to our original value of u. Well, u is x to the 1/3. So instead of writing u, we're going to write that as x to the 1/3. Or what's another way of writing x to the 1/3? What does that really mean? It means the cube root of x. So you could either write it as x to the 1/3 or the cube root of x. Doesn't matter. I'm going to write it as the cube root of x. So I'm now going to do what's called a back substitution. I go back and substitute what u really stands for, which is the cube root of x. And now I need to solve this. All right, so we have a cube root. How do we undo a cube root? We cube it. Cube both sides. Now, if you had written this as x to the 1/3, and you cube it, you'll get x to the first as well. So either way, you would cube both sides. So we get x equals 27. And now we're going to do the same thing over here. And just so you can see, it doesn't matter. I could write this as x to the 1/3 instead of cube root of x. And now we have to cube this because the idea is you want to know what x to the first power is. So 1/3 times 3 is going to give you x to the first. So again, we're going to cube both sides. So it's up to you whether you want to write it as cube root of x or x to the 1/3. But you're still going to have to cube both sides. And this gives us x equals negative 8. So it looks like we have two solutions here for x. But of course, you must check your solutions. So that's going to be our next step. Right, so we've got two solutions to check. We've got to check to make sure 27 is a correct solution and then negative 8. So let's do 27 first. So we've got to put in 27 for x. So we have 27 to the 2/3 minus 27 to the 1/3 minus 6. Now, what does this mean, 27 to the 2/3? It means the cube root of 27 squared minus the cube root of 27 minus 6. Now, if you could do it in your head, you don't need to write that out. I was just doing it as a little reminder. So cube root of 27, what's that? That's 3. So I have 3 squared minus cube root of 27 is 3 minus 6. So 9 minus 3 minus 6, and yeah, that's 0 for sure. And so that checks. So definitely, that's a solution. X is 27. Right? Now let's check to see that negative 8 is a solution as well. Okay, so let's plug in negative 8 for x. We have negative 8 to the 2/3 minus negative 8 to the 1/3 minus 6. And you absolutely must put the negative 8 in parentheses. So what does this mean? This means the cube root of negative 8 squared minus the cube root of negative 8 minus 6. All right, what's the cube root of negative 8? Remember, if it was a square root of negative 8 or the square root of a negative number, we would be in trouble here. But we can take the cube root of a negative, it's still negative. So that's negative 2 squared minus the cube root of negative 8 is negative 2. Make sure you put that in parentheses. So you're subtracting a negative 2 minus 6. Right, what's a negative 2 squared? Well, it's negative 2 times negative 2, that's 4. And then we have minus negative 2, that's plus 2 minus 6. So I have 4 plus 2 minus 6 is 0. Whew! So this is also a solution. So our final answer to this problem is we have two solutions. 27 checked and negative 8 checked. And so we started out with a problem that had rational exponents, and we did this little u substitution and made it look like a quadratic equation, solved it, went back, plugged in that number again for u, and solved for x, checked each solution for x. It's quite a lot. Now, again, you don't have to use substitution, but usually people have trouble factoring when it's in this form. But you can do it. So here's the problem again. If you can just leave everything in terms of x, that's fine. If you want to write that as x to the 1/3 times x to the 1/3, because that's going to give you x to the 2/3, and that'll be your middle term. There's your x to the 1/3, and write minus 3 and plus 2. You can go ahead and do that. Notice I didn't have to say, oh, u is x to the 1/3. And then, in fact, you can write x to the 1/3 as cube root of x minus 3 and cube root of x plus 2 equals 0. And then set each factor equal to 0. Cube root of x minus 3 equals 0, or cube root of x plus 2 equals 0. And set it cube root of x equals 3, cube both sides, and get x equals 27, and do the same thing over on this other side. Cube root of x equals negative 2. Cube both sides. X equals negative 8. Notice I still get the same solutions, negative 8 and 27. And the check is done exactly the same. This is just another way to solve it without having to substitute for u first. It's really up to you. You know, some people prefer to always substitute for u, and some people never want to substitute for u. You have to do it whatever way is easiest for you. You've got options. That is one of the cool things about doing math problems. There isn't usually just one way. There's multiple ways. So this is how to solve, one way to solve a problem with rational exponents, right? Solving an equation with rational exponents and coming up with two solutions and checking.